Drishti IAS is pleased to bring you a program, Mastering Mains Answer Writing, targeting answer writing in Civil Services Mains Examination. We will be alternatively covering GS Papers 1, 2 and 3 through this program. For GS 4, please watch our program, Ethics, Definitions and Concepts. The link for it is mentioned in the description below. The structure of this program covers a GS question as basis for discussion, weightage of topic from which the question is being asked, how to approach the question, how to structure your answer, writing the actual answer, and related previous year's questions from the topic. Let's look at the question we'll be discussing in this episode. The question is, independence of public institutions in a democracy is a barometer of governance. Comment. The question is on the topic governance from the segment Polity and Governance in GS Paper 2. Over the years, the weightage of the topic has ranged between 3 questions in 2018 to as high as 9 questions in 2013. Shifting towards how to approach the question. In general, there are 2 things we have to understand with respect to a question. The underlying theme of the question, what is being asked about that theme. Now let's consider the above question. The underlying theme of the above question is governance. About this theme of governance, importance of independence of public institutions for governance is being asked. Another important step in framing your approach to answer any question is to understand the command word. The command word of this question, comment, requires a brief explanation of the theme, followed by your opinion, reinforcing your point of view using facts and reference to the relevant evidence. Moving towards how to structure the answer. The first part of the answer will be introduction of the answer, which will include a brief explanation of the term governance and its importance. The second part of the answer, that is the body of the answer, will be about the impact of the independence of public institutions on governance in a democracy. Lastly, in our conclusion, we will sum up our answer by suggesting steps that can be taken for strengthening the independence of public institutions. Shifting focus to the actual answer writing. The answer provided here is a representative answer, that is how the actual answer may look like. It can be adapted or modified as per your own natural style of writing, whether paragraph form or short sentences or bullets or diagrams. We have also taken certain liberties with the word limit by including certain additional information in the answer for your comprehensive understanding. Let's look at the answer. Introduction. Governance refers to government in action. It includes the exercise of economic, political, and administrative authority to manage a country's affairs at all levels. Governance is carried out through various interconnected but independent institutions. These institutions form the bedrock of a democracy because they serve the demos, that is the people, by contributing to the development. Body. Importance of independence of public institutions. Independent public institutions ensure good governance by establishing rule of law, transparency, accountability, inclusiveness, and efficiency through the following tools. Regulation. Public institutions as regulatory agencies implement and enforce specific rules and legislations, which in turn ensure better governance in the country. Independence of these regulatory agencies from any political or social interference ensures merit and efficiency in governance. Example, Reserve Bank of India regulates the liquidity in the market to ensure macroeconomic stability. Its independence is necessary from the short-term political compulsions of the government so that it can ensure good fiscal health of the economy. Checks and balances. Checks and balances is the principle of governance under which each of the branches of government limits the power of the other branches, thereby enforcing democratic ideals in the country. Independence of public institutions plays a significant role in ensuring the principle of checks and balances in letter and spirit. This can be explained through the example of how judicial autonomy allows checks and balances on the executive and legislature, thereby upholding and strengthening our constitution. For instance, the National Judicial Appointments Commission was struck down by the Supreme Court in 2015 as it infringes upon the independence of the judiciary. Delivery of services. The delivery of services is vital in creating healthier communities with more inclusive and sustainable outcomes. Independent public institutions prevent any kind of nepotism or favoritism and infuse efficiency, inclusivity, and professionalism in the delivery of services. For example, Election Commission of India is known for its impeccable integrity and professionalism while conducting elections in the largest democracy of the world. Policy formulation. Independence of public institutions ensures framework for debates and deliberations upon public policy matters. For example, the Parliament makes laws and its members are provided independence as they enjoy privileges such as freedom of speech in Parliament, which cannot be questioned in any court of law. Challenges to the independence of public institutions. Across the board, Indian institutions continuously struggle with the three Fs, that is, funding, functions, and functionaries. For these, they are dependent on the government, which makes them vulnerable to political pressure and influence. Moreover, internal accountability mechanisms have largely floundered in these institutions. In nearly all Indian institutions, power remains far too centralized in the hands of the chief. Also, the lack of security of tenure, opacity in operations, and lack of performance-based evaluations provide scope for infringement of their independence. Way forward. Institutions need to become performance-linked, push towards greater efficiency balanced by effectiveness. Media and an aware civil society can play a role in checking the attacks on institutional autonomy. However, the autonomy must be counterbalanced by transparency and accountability. There can be no blind trust of the powerful because of the innate corrupting influence of power. Hence, the greater the autonomy of an institution, the greater the need of inserting robust instruments of transparency and accountability. At the end, let's have a look on previous year's questions. In 2018, the questions asked were related to the policy contradictions that have resulted in inadequate protection and prevention of degradation to the environment. The other questions were related to e-governance and citizen charter. In 2017, 5 questions were asked. They were related to Public Accounts Committee, National Commission for Women, self-help groups, poverty alleviation programs and their performance, as well as questions related to reforms required in civil services. In 2016, the questions asked were related to the role of non-state actors in governance, demographic dividend, effectiveness of government systems, and the interdependence of people's participation. The other questions were related to factors that have caused the decline of public morality in India, responsiveness to liberalization, privatization, and globalization, as well as the traditional bureaucratic structure and its impact on development. In 2015, 6 questions were asked related to the Foreign Contribution Regulation Act or the FCRA 1976, self-help group bank linkage program, role of NGOs for development works, Whistleblowers Protection Act, and the independence and autonomy of regulatory institutions. In 2014, 8 questions were asked from this segment. The relation between the efficacy of the government and the size of the cabinet. Next, FDI and news media, its pros and cons. Proposed reforms in the Indian Railways. Self-help groups. And the state-sponsored talent hunt and its cultivation as against the rationale of a reward system for encouragement in sports persons. The other 3 questions were related to the academic independence in premier education institutions, cadre-based civil services organization, as well as Aadhaar and NPR. In 2013, the questions were related to how smaller states can bring effective governance at state level, merger of 2 regulatory agencies, namely the SEBI and IRDA, self-help groups, restructuring of centrally sponsored schemes, electronic cash transfer, providing urban amenities in rural areas, citizen charters, and Lokpal. That is all for this episode. We will see you next time with a question from GS Paper 3. Stay tuned.